Hello, you may be a student, or like myself, a member, working in a business or some form of non-profit organization. However, like most entities, you're very likely affected by the current COVID-19 virus in some way or another. If you happen to be active in a travel-related business, such as airlines, hotels, or car hire, you will certainly have personal experience of how difficult this phase is. Conversely, if you're active in a healthcare-related business, you may be finding it difficult to keep up with an explosion in customer demand. Regardless of the type of business, COVID-19 will pass, and those businesses with strong, talented, and committed management teams will emerge stronger. I say that because there is a positive correlation between the strength of management and the company's financial health. As the crisis unfolded, we at CareChair created a crisis management team and initiated a series of actions. In January, travel to and from China was suspended, followed by a global travel ban in early February. Reducing the risk of staff infection was our first priority. In addition, many specific measures were introduced, and in several countries, visitors were not allowed to access any of our company sites. We developed various business scenarios, including a worst-case outcome, to test the limits of our potential exposure. We introduced twice-monthly rolling sales and profit forecasts and weekly cash flow projections. Generally, the quality was and remains high, but is clearly highest for those teams that really understand the drivers of customer demand, can initiate appropriate countermeasures, and thereby more accurately predict customer demand. Our finance teams play a central role in quantifying assumptions, analyzing data, and creating transparency. We have postponed several capital investment projects to conserve cash, but we also need to understand when it still makes sense to invest. No short-term decision should harm the long-term development of the business. Likewise, we separate our discretionary spending from what we consider to be essential because we want to maintain our capability throughout and after this current crisis. We now benefit from the investment we make in people development. Last year, we started 4 high performers on the SEMA CGMA program. In return for their commitment to the business, we fund their studies through to qualification and also expose them to different parts of the business so that they can gain valuable practical experience. Since then, we have funded another 2 members of staff who privately embarked on the program, and another 2 staff members will very likely start their studies by the end of the year. These young people are developing strong technical and business skills. Their inputs to our planning and forecasting are supported by sound business understanding. As they develop, their confidence grows, as does the accuracy of their work. What initially seemed quite a demanding task has now become more routine. Our finance team members are happy to regularly exchange views with colleagues in different parts of the organization and seek out new insights. They really understand that there's never been a better time to become a management accountant. Thank you.